Oh boy, this is really become to be expected from the New York Jets. Just another bad performance, not just overall, but on national TV, for crying out loud. I said last week that if Bowles did not beat the 49ers, then the Jets would be even more of a laughing stock. Well, you lose again on national TV, you make a bigger idiot out of yourself than you already have before as an NFL head coach. And that is where I bring the point of Todd Bowles in. Last night, he didn't even look in. I just don't know what to say. Other than the fact that he didn't look like he wanted to coach. Trust me, if you're a guy like that and you know your team is crappy than it's ever been before, then you know what I'm talking about. Now, let's bring up Petty. That is yet another embarrassing moment in the New York Jets franchise history. It's bad enough Mark Sanchez had that famous butt fumble game in 2012. We all know that story. Well, if I got the year wrong, you can criticize me in the comments. But let's talk about how Dominican Sue and Cameron Wake, the fourth quarter, literally pounded the life out of Bryce Petty. It's just, I want to know something. And a lot of you people are going to agree with me on this if you've seen the highlights. Where was the offensive line? Because I've been thinking about it since last night, believe me. And they need to rebuild it. They have to. You got to get rid of Mangold. NFL teams, in some cases, take years to rebuild an offensive line. The Jets, however, in this case, they are in that situation. They have to rebuild the offensive line. As far as defense, the only defense I can give credit to is the Dolphins. And let's just bring up how the Dolphins threw a 11-yard blocked punt return. Walt Aiken. How in the world does that even happen? An 11-yard block punt return on special teams. How? Can somebody explain me that? Because I can't. Even when I'm reading it from what I have from my monologue today, it clearly, now we're in another black hole with this mediocre NFL franchise. The Jets have now entered a new dark hole. Except this isn't Rex Ryan we're talking about. This is Todd Bowles. This is another defensive coach mistake. I'm going to be honest. The next two games are not going to be easy for the Jets. You got to play New England on Christmas Eve, which is bad enough as it is. Even if you're playing against Garoppolo or Brady, which in my opinion, the Patriots should rest Brady anyway, seeing why should he play against a crappy Jet team. You don't even know, this is the big factor here, who is starting next week for the New York Jets? We don't know how serious this injury is to Petty. So what are you going to do? Bring back the same failing quarterback who got you in this possession, and that is Fitzpatrick? I'm telling you. Petty's not ready this week. They have got to start Hackenberg. You have to see what you have. I know he isn't ready, but give Hackenberg a chance, for crying out loud. You're not going, you obviously are going to get a top 10 draft pick anyway in the first round. So just start Hackenberg. That's all you should do if you're Todd Bowles. And listen, I'm just a guy behind a microphone giving my reaction to this awful, awful disaster of a game, where I don't even need to read anything else off this monologue today, because I will literally get more annoyed talking about it. But all I can say is this. At 4-10, they're going to finish 4-12. There is no way they're beating the Patriots. And there is no way they're even going to beat the Bills in Week 17. They beat Buffalo in Week 17. I will be stunned if they end up 5-11. But that's still going to get you, at the end of the day, a top 10 draft pick in the NFL draft. So, that was my reaction to this awful, awful Jet game. And